still can.
And him in my purse. Or on one side, there's just on one of those outside. Hi.
Yeah, she's talking. It's all right.
Kelly. Good morning, St. Angelo.
Hello.
Welcome to Derailed.
Welcome to Derailed. It's a typical show.
We're starting
off like this. Yeah. It's great. All right.
So, we have a new guest today.
We do. Kelly Duncan is here with us. Hi, Kelly. How are you?
Hi, David. Hello.
Jeff. Jeff Caldwell.
Very nice to meet you officially, Jeff.
Yeah, I just walked into the studio just a couple of minutes ago.
Well,
into the
so did Kelly. She ran in here, too.
Yeah.
Which I was impressed. That was a nice run down the hallway.
I know.
In those shoes.
In those shoes. An hour ago.
Yeah, where were you an hour ago? You were telling me?
Flower beds 1 hour ago.
That's impressive.
Mm-hmm.
Were you working in your flower beds in this particular outfit?
No. Not today, but I can be found at any time, at any moment. If it so strikes me.
Yeah.
All right.
Could be an address.
You know, gardening is a gratifying hobby.
It is.
I don't want to say hobby, pursuit.
It is only if you can grow stuff.
That's the challenge.
My wife has the blackest green thumb you'll ever see in your entire life. She's killed just about every plant, I think, that we've ever owned. That's why we have a yard guy who takes care of everything else.
Right.
She does have some plants out there, some succulents, which in this heat, they're fine. I mean, you water them once a week and you're okay. So remembering to water them is the good thing for her. So
I've had one garden, and right after it came up, it was beaten to the ground with a hailstorm.
Oh, wow. Hailstorms will do that, yeah.
This was 5 years ago, May, 5 years ago. And I then grew the biggest, luscious tomatoes. Enormous.
Really? What kind of tomatoes were they?
I don't know. Red ones.
Okay.
I
don't
know. Big. They were big ones. That's
they
what they
were. Big and yummy. And
big
juicy.
Tomatoes.
And I had tomatoes until November.
Wow.
I had so many green ones.
That's fantastic.
Then we made, I think, chow chow.
Mmm.
It was yummy.
We started a garden in our backyard at the beginning of the summer,
right?
Which was maybe a little early. No, it was right around the end of spring. But we have tomatoes that are now making it. Mostly cherry tomatoes are growing, but we're starting to get some larger ones. We have watermelons, although this vine that's stretching halfway across the yard has produced two watermelons. One of them split because it got too dry.
Yeah,
didn't quite get enough water. We have cucumber, squash, cantaloupe.
Well, why aren't you like selling at the farmer's market, dude? You should
Right, this is our first garden, so we're getting plants.
You're experimenting,
like two
and
fruits.
I know we just met, but share the love.
Bring us some veggies, Jeff.
Some
come
of that
on.
Stuff actually starts producing. Then
maybe we could actually give them away on Derailed on the actual webcast today.
Maybe
that'll derail us into hey, it's vegetable giveaway day.
I mean, generally
from Jeff's garden.
I'm generally of the school that under promises and over delivers. So
so every other farmer. No, I'm just kidding.
I try not
just
to over promise too much.
So Kelly, obviously, our guest here today on Derailed, but with the ConchoValley Republican Women's.
Republican Women, yes. I'm the vice president of the ConchoValley, St. Angelo Republican Women.
That's right.
I'm
true. Sorry. Yeah. I shouldn't say that.
Mm-hmm. I need to engage my brain. I'm just so excited about
no one engages their brain on this show. They really don't.
We don't. Generally, no.
But the San Angelo Republican Women, and we're the new group.
Right.
We've been chartered since January.
Okay.
And our motto is boots on the ground. And so we're very actively growing our membership, growing our party awareness and our presence in the community. And talking to lots of people. And, you know, we have a big election coming up in 2020, in November of 2020. But then we have other elections before then.
Right.
Right. We do have an election coming up.
This November.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And there are several constitutional amendments to the Texas Constitution that people will be voting upon. And
I've read 10 or 12, right? 10? Was it?
I think there's 10. I have them on my phone. I looked it up recently and so I would be educated about them, and I still need more education.
I've forgotten since we posted the story about...
I want to say 10 is right, but I can't remember either.
I think it's 10. Yay, there we are. Mm-hmm.
We're on, yeah.
We're on. But, and we have monthly meetings, and you're more than welcome to come because we do.
Even guys?
Even guys. We have guy membership.
Okay, all right.
And they are associate members.
Okay.
And we have quite a number of associate members. And they're not just the husbands of the membership because it is open to the public. We're open for anyone. You know, it's all about learning and being, you want to be around like-minded people, but we also want to bring people in and just educate them about lots of things.
It's important for people to be involved in politics, especially at a local level.
And to be informed about politics in general, because the more informed voters are your voters that are probably voting the way that they should.
Right.
Not the way you want them to, but the way that they should vote. Because, you know, I've told friends for a number of years, I've never been a straight ticket party voter.
Right.
I vote for the people that I think are best for the particular office that they're running for. And if that's a Democrat, if it's a liberal, if it's a independent person, or if it's Republican or however. But the best thing to do is to be informed about the issues and the candidates that you are voting for.
Right.
So.
And I think that is right.
Over the years, what a lot of people have lost sight of is how important it is to be involved on a local level.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody focuses very much on national elections.
Well, and you know, it's crazy because I hate to admit it, but for the longest time, you know, obviously you can vote when you're 18.
Right.
And I'll admit this on the show. I hate to say it, but I did. From the time I was 18 until I was 26, I never voted.
Wow.
I did not vote in an election. I know. It's terrible to say. And it was Drew Darby, our state representative.
Okay.
Obviously, I got to know Drew from being at the TV station and here. And Drew and I were talking one day offset before a newscast. And we were talking, and I admitted to him at that particular point in my life that I had never voted as a, you know, an 18 to 26-year-old person. And he was like, wow, David. He said, well, and I can understand your point of view, because I was very frustrated with politicians at that age.
It's,
because they would say one thing, then they would get in office and not do what they had said they were going to do. Obviously, there are other factors and things that don't allow them maybe to do a particular thing once they get in office, even though that was their campaign promise.
Right.
So Drew and I had that whole conversation, and I just – we came to the agreement that he said, David, really, on a local level, he said, if you don't want to vote for the president, you don't want to vote for your, you know, congressman or whatever, he said, I can understand that. He said, but you need to understand at a local level, your mayor, your county commissioners, your city council people, those are people that can really affect your life, your day-to-day living.
Exactly right.
And he said, so I would be informed and at least vote in those elections. And I'd never thought of it that way. And so after that conversation with Drew, I really did some, I guess,
soul searching,
and decided it was better to be informed. And I was kind of being, for lack of a better term, I was contradicting myself as a news person, you know, being informed. I was not informing myself about something because I didn't like it.
Right.
And so politics wasn't my thing, so I didn't like it, so I just hands off. And I didn't really, like, bash politics or anything along those realms, but I just didn't inform myself. But now, many years later, because I'm not 26 anymore, let's just say it. So
maybe it's
been voting for a long time now.
26th anniversary of your...
Well, I'll be 49 next month. Let's just go
ahead.
Birthday. Yeah, so there we go. Yeah, my 23rd voting birthday, if you want to go there.
I did, you know, what really changed my view on local elections was... there was a writer who reframed politics for me and said, you know, a lot of people think of politics as what people in power do to everybody.
Right.
And you need to think about politics as the way that citizens and adults manage their social life. Social life being their life in society.
Sure.
Not going out to dinner or whatever.
Right.
But it's really like everybody participating to manage, the way that everybody participates to manage their society. That's politics. And it's, that made sense to me.
Okay.
It does, yeah.
And I think it's one of those things that it's finding your own. Like Drew and Mai's conversation is what helped me find where I needed to be involved and inform myself to make good decisions when I'm voting.
Yeah.
And to vote in general. So, and just like you said, the writer spoke to you. So,
and that brings me to two things.
Sure.
I found my voice to become involved. I always voted. I would listen to the ads. Mm-hmm. I'd go to the polling booth and, yeah, I remember that guy, yeah. And I mean, I had to say that because I'm much older than both of you. I'm not old enough to be your mothers, but I am much older. I have been voting since 1978, I'll say that. Okay. No, no, yeah, 1978. But where I've always believed in the political process. I, like you, voted, and I think it's a West Texas thing that you vote for the person.
Sure.
But now I think we're going the other direction on that because we're now so bipartisan. But I don't want to get off on that discussion just yet. But
we'll derail on that in a minute.
We'll derail because I do want to make 2 points. I am a firm believer in the political process. Where I found my footing was during the Senator Ted Cruz campaign for re-election.
Okay.
Because, and I'm not going to go off here and say, yay here, yay here, yay here. But I'm just going to say that I knew that I wanted to support Senator Cruz. And because there was an event and it was very, I was very surprised at locally, talking about local participation, how people were so over the top about a particular candidate. And I thought, what can I do to do my part so people will know how I feel?
Right.
Because all these people are so vocal. And I knew how I felt, but I never talked. We've known each other a long, long time.
Mm-hmm. And we've never talked politics.
We've never talked politics.
Yeah.
We just met, and look, we're just petties. But so as I laid there in my bed that night at 11:30 at night, what can I do? I have 2,600 Facebook friends. I'm just going to put how I feel on Facebook. And now I have a whole lot more. I'm
right.
less a few friends. But
I started to say, how many defriended you when you did that? So
had a few nasty things. But, yeah. That's okay. That's their choice. I believe you can feel one way and you can feel another. And
sometimes we have to agree to disagree and live
exactly right.
as human beings
well,
together.
We still have to live in the same society.
Yeah.
That's right.
We do.
And so that, we all find our political step in different ways. Yours was with Drew Darby.
Mm-hmm.
Mine was seeing the excitement of a particular group of people. And so that's how I found my voice and my step. And that's how I came to be involved with the San Angelo Republican Women. Because there was a group of women that noticed what I was doing.
Mm-hmm.
And they asked me to get involved with them.
And they were like-minded with you and said, hey, yeah.
Yeah, I'm like, all right, let's do it. And I've completely forgotten what the second thing I was going to say. Oh, yeah, voting. The upcoming elections. If you are not registered to vote, you have until October 7th to register to vote.
That's important.
So get registered.
Good information, yeah.
That is the first step you do in casting your ballot. And there are just a few requirements. You have to be 18 years old, a current resident of your county. And, I'm probably going to say the wrong thing because I am not a certified voter registrar. I just know what some of the steps are.
Sure.
But you can go to the county elections office downtown in the
MPs.
Vonna
is the best.
Vonna.
I love Vonna. Yeah, so I covered so many elections with her, and she knows all of the rules
all
and
of
laws
the rules.
And everything.
And there aren't very many.
Right.
No.
But
and for anybody who's lived in San Angelo for a while, the elections office is in the same building that the library used to be in.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Ed McKee's.
It's the old.
Mm-hmm. And you just walk in there and boom. And I there's also training available to become the certified voter registrar, voter registrar.
Yeah.
And those are held every month. I just haven't, I'm kind of busy.
Sure. You do have a few things going on.
I have a few things going on, but.
And your garden.
And my flower beds are amazing.
Nice. So what kind of flowers do you have?
Gerber daisies.
Gerber daisies are nice.
And I didn't realize they would be so hardy. Because I do have a yard guy. And I asked him to plant. I said, just plant some stuff. And when I saw that they were Gerber daisies, I was like, oh, man, that's just going to die. But they haven't.
And even in the heat, huh?
Even in the heat. I don't know how, because there's no shade. But then I have a lot of... those are the big ones
right.
that I like to talk about, because they have survived. Well, I have one that kicked the bucket, but that was my fault. And then
overwatered it?
I think I did.
Mm-hmm.
I really do think I overwatered it, because it was in kind of a low spot and the water kind of hung there and it just didn't flourish.
Yeah.
But, and then I have, and see, these are new flower beds.
Right.
I've always done potted plants. So I have a bunch of that really cool tall grass that I planted. I bought a bunch for some wedding decor that I needed. And I thought, I'm just going to put it. So great. Perfect. You know, they look great. And then we have some of that other little green stuff. And I have some pansies, some of the typical stuff. And see, I don't know the names of some.
We were
of
just
them.
Talking politics, and now we're talking pansies.
Hey.
Yeah.
It's almost synonymous, right? I didn't say that. Politicians.
We're all fired.
Yep. Yep. It's all right. Last derailed webcast ever.
Y'all are the professionals.
We have a little more leeway with what we get to say on derailed than we do on the newscast.
Until corporate finds out, we're good.
Yeah. Oh, but backtracking to politics and the San Angelo Republican women. We do meet.
Y'all have an event coming up, right?
Yes. I could talk about a couple of different events. But one in particular, Monday, September 9th.
Okay.
That's the Monday after Labor Day. We have District Judge Carmen Dusick going to be as our guest speaker.
Oh, wow.
And talking about the court system and what each of the different courts do.
Oh, so, that sounds like actually a really interesting.
I think it's going to be a very interesting.
Jeff will be an associate member by then.
Hey, you can be a guest. You don't have to be an associate member.
He'll come cover it, I'm sure. We'll make Jeff come by.
I'll cover it.
So
good.
Tell people about what the different courts do.
Because he's interested in that kind of stuff. So.
Yeah, I was actually thinking about doing a series on how the criminal justice system works in Texas and Tom Green County.
Oh.
Because it's
there you go.
I think probably confusing.
We're your group.
I lived away for a long time and I didn't understand the way the different courts worked.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And I did recently take a Texas government class and that cleared up most of that.
See, Jeff informs himself. That's what I like about Jeff.
Awesome.
So
I'm so glad you did it that way, because some people know about our criminal justice system
through Facebook.
Yeah, or maybe because
they're
on
in
a first-hand
it?
Basis. Yeah,
because they might be a member of the criminal justice system.
But we meet at 6 p.m. at the West Texas Rehab Conference Center.
It's not
the building on the corner. It's the building right next
door. The new building they put up between Glenn Middle School and there. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, because there's a little circle drive.
Yep.
That's where y'all meet in that little room right there.
And let me tell you what. They have that conference center. There are lots of organizations that meet there.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a fabulous facility. It has a capacity of about 100 people, but there's a very nice modern kitchen in there.
Mm-hmm.
You know, if you're going to have some food or beverage...
For your get-together.
For our get-together. Mm-hmm. They have tables and chairs for 100 and then some spare seating, you know, to set up for extra seating. We had Nick Adams, he's an award-winning author. He's a Fox News contributor. We had him last month. He's also an Australian who's become a U.S. citizen. He's really an interesting guy. I tell everybody he's my favorite Australian. But we had him
just because he has an accent, right?
Yeah, but he's just a good guy.
It's the accent.
Don't lie.
A good guy. I know.
It's all about the accent.
Well, he brought his parents.
Hi, Sarah. Sarah's watching. So.
Hey.
Yeah. We love for all of our folks to tune in and pay attention. Yes, it is kind of a podcast, Bobby. It is a webcast. Derailed is the name of the show, so people are kind of getting in. So, but that's what we do here every day from 11 to 12. Derailed is the webcast that we do, and we get derailed on all different types
all
of topics.
Yeah.
Today, Kelly Duncan is our special guest with us, so Jeff Caldwell and I, and then usually Cody Brown, who's on vacation, joins us. And we're going to be... Some really cool things coming up with our webcast and stuff that we're doing here on Concha Valley Homepage real soon. So we'll tell you more about that in the upcoming few months, I'm Absolutely. Sure, and let you know more about it. But Kelly, your first time on, and we have not followed our path, what we always do. So let's kind of get on it.
So there was one other thing that I wanted to talk about.
Okay, before we get there. All right.
Since we were talking about educating ourselves.
Sure.
Handsome McHandsome Hay, named professor at University of Texas.
I think Kelly is probably going to go take a class at UT, aren't you?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Oscar-winning actor Matthew McConaughey will join the University of Texas as a professor, who this fall will teach in the university's Department of Radio, Television, Film.
So did you find that out? Because we had this conversation this morning, Jeff and I. So we were trying to decide if he's really going to be
a professor?
Professor McConaughey, because I was trying to think, do you have to have your doctorate to be called professor in a teaching...
I actually got derailed on my own research of this because I started looking
at
it.
So you didn't get the answer for me?
Something else came up and I had to take care of that, and then another thing and another thing, and then it was 2 minutes before we had to do this show.
Oh, so, yeah.
So, according to the Associated Press, he is going to be named a professor.
Oh, okay.
McConaughey has been a visiting instructor at the flagship campus in Austin since 2015.
Oh.
And the university said in a statement Wednesday that the appointment recognizes his outstanding work as a teacher and mentor.
Hmm.
So he's going to be teaching a script to screen film production.
I can't remember which graduation it was, but he gave a speech at a graduation, and I actually printed that speech out. Wow. I have that copy of that speech because it was really a phenomenal speech.
I haven't seen it on my YouTube.
Yeah, so you can watch it online because a lot of people have it in there. But to listen to him at that graduation,
right?
And the things that he said, I was really impressed. And I've never been like a huge Matthew McConaughey fan, but after that speech, I was like, I like you a lot more.
Well, I lived in Austin for a really short period of time, maybe a year, and even then, they had Bongo Naked stickers.
Yeah,
I forgot about that.
A long time ago.
Oh wow!
But this is
banging the drums naked,
right? And his, I guess, the myth of a famous person just sort of hangs around Texas with McConaughey.
Sure.
Because, a couple of months ago, he went through the drive-thru at Whataburger.
Oh, right.
And everybody
put it on news, Sherwood Way.
Right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And I was in class on Monday, and McConaughey's name came up, and two people behind me, one of them was like, he lives here. And I was like,
he has a ranch outside of here.
Right.
So.
Yeah. But regardless of that, it's probably really an interesting class because performers or teachers are performers in their own way.
Oh, sure.
Or good ones are.
Yeah.
And I think what's so cool about Matthew, you can't even talk when she's talking about it.
She gets all
McHandsome
like...
McHandsome Man?
Mm-hmm. McHandsome Man, yes.
That would be the best way for her to describe it.
You can't say McDreamy or McHottie. That's a whole nother derailed subject. But because Matthew McConaughey is all on his own. But I think... So just to listen to us, he's so approachable.
Right.
And he's so normal seeming, but yet...
Compared to most Hollywood superstars.
Oh, yeah. I'm not going to name any because he's just so approachable. And besides that, my son's going to kill me. I've always thought he looks like my son. Not my son looks like him, but he looks like my son because my son is very handsome and tall and approachable, successful. McHandsome son, but anyway, so that's my two cents, and I love him, and if he were playing a dog catcher, I'd go watch him and think he was the best.
He's probably great at it.
Maybe we should do our top 10 Matthew McConaughey films today.
We could do that.
We could derail and go to that, because I know we had another subject for today already, because someone had kind of said something to me, but...
Yeah, we were going to do a continuation of the one from yesterday, but,
But yeah, we might do that.
It's not like I've got
some top 10 films that I liked him in.
Right, it's not we produce this show meticulously or anything.
No, we do not.
So, let's get to National Days today.
All right.
More herbs, less salt day.
Yeah, since you were working in your garden before you got here. So today, the 29th of August, is more herbs, less salt day.
Eating a healthy, balanced diet is often easier said than done. It takes thought, time, and effort to prepare fresh and nutritious food when less healthy options are much easier and more convenient.
Now, if you caught ConchoValley this morning, Jay Martin, our meteorologist, was talking about another day today.
Oh.
The 29th is Chop Suey Day.
Uh-oh.
As well. So if you look there, Chop Suey Day in the bottom left. Yeah. So have you ever had Chop Suey?
Yeah.
I've never had chop suey, to be honest. I eat all kinds of other Chinese food, but not chop suey.
My mother used to make it when I was growing up.
Really?
And I used to think, wow, that's so cool.
So, National Chop Suey Day today.
Mm-hmm. That's pretty cool.
You have to go find a local Chinese restaurant and find some chop suey and try it, because I've never had it. It's a traditional Chinese dish. So
I know where they had some, but I don't. Can I say the name?
Sure.
The new sushi place, Masa.
Oh, I've been there. It was really good.
Yes, it's
yeah.
Awesome.
My wife and I went there the other day and tried it, and it's where they had the Cajun place. Cajun Creations was there by Cinemark, and so we went and tried it the other night. Actually, had a date night. Got out of the house.
Oh,
you know, so 14-month-old.
Very
you know how
necessary.
That is. So got out of the house and actually had a little date night, and went there to eat, and it was really good. So
and it pretty inside.
Yeah, and the presentation of how they brought out the sushi was great.
The
we got the. The scorpion roll. And so it came out in the shape of a scorpion.
Wow.
So, yeah, it was done really,
sushi's
really
great.
Cool. So.
It's really great there.
Yeah.
No. Go try it.
We've tried the other sushi place that's in that same shopping center as Whataburger on Sherwood. I don't remember the name of it. I'm sorry.
Nakamura.
Yeah, it's Nakamura.
Shelby's
Nakamura. Shelby.
Sorry, I'm in
House
the
of Teriyaki.
Oh,
sometimes.
House of Teriyaki. Yeah,
that's
a
separate
one.
Nakamura is the sushi place that's behind Whataburger. In the Commons. Smaller place. Really good. Locally owned. A friend of mine actually started. I don't know if she still owns it or not.
I could have I could be mixing either of these up. So.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. But House of Teriyaki is not bad either. So we got that delivered once.
I have not been there.
You haven't? It was actually
might have
pretty
actually
good.
Gone to Nakamura.
You might have.
Yeah.
Jeff, do you know where you are right now?
No. You know what I do know? It's individual.
Do you know? Can you say it, though, Jeff? You may know, but you can't just say it.
It is Individual Rights Day.
Individual rights? What does that mean?
Oh, my.
In honor of John Locke, whose philosophical writings argued for the rights of each single human being. Man, what am I doing?
I don't
Individual
know.
Rights Day is celebrated on August 29th, the date of Locke's birth. Yeah.
Well,
since I've butchered the pronunciation of that
today is actual... Actually, too, Pottery's Bottle Oven Day.
That's neat.
Do you have any idea what Pottery's Bottle Oven Day is?
I don't.
I don't either.
Bottle Oven.
But I'm
going to
read it. The Gladstone Pottery Museum in Stoke-on-Trent and hit the national headlines in print and broadcast media. It was a proud day for the potteries and was described as the biggest cultural event of the 20th century.
Wow.
So, and I'm assuming it's these
it's
things
those,
that you
it's
can see.
Be the shape
Pottery's
of the,
Bottle
of the oven,
oven Day. It looks like a, yeah. Like a bottle is what it looks like, but it's their ovens. So.
Well, we have Lemon Juice Day. That's important.
Lemon juice is important.
Yeah. Everybody,
especially
maybe
have,
not everybody likes
when
it.
When you have fish,
and
you need some lemon juice on.
As it has been for the rest of the month, it is Anti-Frizz Month.
As
no
Kelly adjusts her hair.
As I sprayed myself with the wand as I was, so, yes.
As you
I
were
cannot.
Trying to get out of the garden and over here.
So we managed to take up half an hour already.
I know. So are we
so
just going to skip?
We can just go right into top 10 if you guys want.
That's fine with me. So are we going to do top 10?
Let's do top 10 Matthew McConaughey movies.
Yes. I like that, since in honor of Professor McConaughey, starting at UT.
That's right.
There's so many. He's done so many. We just recently watched one, and we talked about it the other day, the Dallas Buyers Club. We had not seen that, and we watched it the other night, and it was actually really a good movie. So,
isn't that one of his more serious roles?
Yeah, it's where he was. He played the individual who ended up getting AIDS.
Yes. Did
you know,
not
a cowboy.
See that one.
And it's a good movie, but he lost so much weight. It was hard to almost watch McConaughey because he had lost so much weight
Didn't
in that.
He lose
so,
like 45
it was,
pounds.
It, yeah, it was ridiculous.
It
yeah,
was.
It was. He was thin.
I just want to lose.
He
10,
was thin.
You know.
But apparently, some of these actors will go to extremes in order to lose that weight. They'll do like whiskey and cigarette diets. And
oh
stuff
yeah,
like that.
And he's bulked
whiskey?
Up before and
whiskey and cigarettes.
That's my diet currently. Not
whiskey.
The cigarettes.
Not the cigarettes, but There's a new one.
A new McConaughey movie?
No, a new whiskey.
Oh, really? There we go.
Sorry, back to McHanson.
No, we can go to that. That's fine with me. If you see one of these that you want to talk about, Kelly, you just tell me. Okay, is that one you want to go with? Go ahead. Because we don't really do 10 to 1.
Yeah,
I was going to ask. Are we going 10 to 1, 1 to 10?
It's
or
not so
pick
much
em?
A ranking.
You can just kind of pick and we'll talk.
Yeah.
How to Lose a Guy in 10 Days.
All right.
I mean, classic. They're the cutest couple. He's adorable, and he's sweet, and he's adorable. Did I say he's adorable? Yeah. And he's handsome.
McAdorable.
He's a McAdorable. I don't know. I really like that one. But then again, I'm
derailing.
I love The Lincoln Lawyer.
Oh, see,
I love the. And
you're about to. Because that's probably one of my all-time favorite Matthew McConaughey movies.
And talk about being so serious, but yet he was just so cool in that movie. And you're cool, and the music was so good in that. You can look on my playlist. After that movie, I bought the soundtrack. And there's hardly any words in any of the songs. But
so this was,
it was just a good movie.
Talking about how was it going.
Oh,
well,
sorry,
we were,
so
but
I'm
we derailed to The Lincoln Lawyer. Oh, so we went
so
to two
cool.
of them, so...
Okay. He was so cool.
Well, let me pull up footage for Lincoln Lawyer.
Okay.
It's interesting because How to Lose a Guy in 10 Days was sort of the period of his career when he was doing a lot of rom-coms.
Right. Romantic comedies.
Right. And the
if
joke...
you don't know that term.
The joke online rom-com. Was sort of that he... All the posters for those movies, as you can see here, he was leaning.
He just
almost all of those, almost all of the movie posters for that, he's leaning up against something.
Ghost of Girlfriend's Past. Yeah. He's leaning into the hands.
Oh,
yeah.
I forgot about that one. That was cute. Mm-hmm. Oh, and that one, I remember that
one. Oh, yeah, Fool's Gold was a good one. Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh. This was
good. We're going so fast for Jeff. He can't even pull trailers up
and
fast enough for it.
And that's why I'm not saying any names. I'm just pointing.
The Lincoln Lawyer was, it's probably one of my favorite all-time Matthew McConaughey movies because he just...
I am trying to... I don't know.
Have you not seen this, Jeff? It's really a good movie. You would enjoy it, I think. So.
How old are you? Because I know you're younger because maybe that was like in a time when you might have been in college or something.
2011?
Oh.
Were you living in New York then?
I was living in New York. I should have been able to see this.
Yeah.
Well,
I just didn't.
But The Lincoln Lawyer was one of what I consider Matthew McConaughey's better roles for me. I really enjoyed him in that movie. So, but he did a good
John
job.
John Leguizamo. That's great.
Oh yeah, it's a good movie.
I'm always a fan of anything with John Leguizamo.
It's a good Except waste of your time, Jeff, to watch that movie. I would say, good waste of your time. So.
All right, we've got a suggestion from Tammy Corder Brown.
Okay.
A Time to Kill.
That's a great one.
Wow.
And let's see, is that Samuel Jackson, right?
I think so. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That was with him. Yeah.
Yes.
Yep.
What, the late '90s, right?
Mm-hmm. '96, I want to say.
Yeah.
'96, '95, somewhere in there.
In the title.
Oh.
Which one? Did you see one that you liked? We'll go to that one in a minute.
Oh, yeah, we got to go to that one. Mm-hmm. Oh, see, I'm looking at some of these. I don't even...
And you don't remember that he was actually a part of some of these movies.
Oh, I know.
We kind of Google and looked through it. But,
wow, they are both young looking.
That was that was a great movie the social stuff that was in there.
And this was almost... it goes very close to Kill a Mockingbird.
Yes.
Right.
The themes that happen in this movie, except for the crime that he's
right.
And I think this might have been his first really serious role.
I think it was one of them. Yeah,
It kind of was a turning point in his career. I mean, as far as I'm concerned, because I looked at him in a completely different light after this. He was still so young, but and he was just such a good guy. You know, such a good. Man, he played such a good man.
Yeah.
And
all right, so Jeff, are you going to get one in?
I'm going to get one in.
You're going to have to do it quickly cuz Kelly's.
But this is actually related. If I can actually find the trailer for it. This is I believe a Steven Spielberg movie.
Wow.
That was also made in the 90s. Amistad.
I never
saw
that one.
He plays a lawyer in this as well.
Yeah.
this is about the ship Amistad that was full of slaves.
Mm-hmm.
And I have not seen this movie in a long time, but I believe that what the slaves did is they had a revolt on the ship.
Right. I forgot that McConaughey was in that, to be honest.
So. Yeah, he's not necessarily the main character.
Right.
I never saw that.
You never saw this? Yeah, it's really good.
Speaking of...
I know. We'll get there.
I've just got two more.
She saw two more. So, yeah, that's one of all. We'll get to that one in a second. I'm gonna jump just a couple of years ago, okay. 2016, and we talked about the other day, Free State of Jones.
That was a great movie.
Which was a great movie if you have not seen that. Mm-hmm. And, you know, it's funny that some of his roles, kind of like you're talking about Amistad and the slaves there and Free State of Jones, the way it was set, there's some themes that he kind of goes with as far as choosing roles and stuff. So
yeah, there are some similar themes that go through a lot of the things that he makes. This is really interesting because what the main thing that comes up in this is a lot of the people who have to carry out a war that's declared are very poor.
Right.
That's right.
And they're fighting specifically what his main character's beef in this movie is. Mm-hmm. They're fighting for slavery.
Someone else.
Right. Right.
And mm-hmm. But the slavery does not benefit them.
No, right. Not at all.
The slavery is for rich landholders.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And so they declare their own free state.
But that's why. Mm-hmm. That's why I would say that's probably one of McConaughey's top ten roles in my opinion. So,
yeah, that's a really
and everything that you said, and one thing that I took out of it because I am a female, even
you're a female,
and, yeah.
Oh,
David,
and I garden, you know, but
derailed. Yes, you can punch me.
But,
you can punch me. Make sure the camera's on us.
Yeah,
the free state is that, you know. He was completely free. I mean, he fell in love with a slave,
right?
Which was forbidden.
Oh, yeah.
And you know, that was something else. Because I've watched this movie at the movie theaters. I went to see it twice.
Oh, really?
Yes. And then I can't remember if it was on one of the pay-per-views or if I watched it on Netflix or whatever. But I've seen it three more times.
Mm.
So
wow.
But so that's how much I enjoyed the movie. I enjoyed all of the characters,
right?
And how he truly was free.
Hmm. It was definitely a good movie.
Yes.
I enjoyed it.
Yes.
So if you're just joining us here on Derailed, we're doing our top 10 Matthew McConaughey movies in honor of Matthew McConaughey being named a professor at UT, the film school. So
Tammy's got another suggestion.
Okay. Which is? Oh. Really? Really, Tammy? Okay.
David's already said he doesn't like this movie.
No.
I'm
just going to leave the webcast now.
Before I cut to it, though.
Before this trailer ever gets up.
So funny. It's going to be a second. I love to keep everybody in suspense.
Yeah, you do.
I'm sure everybody watching already knows what
just for that
about.
Reason. Well, they think they know.
Oh, wait.
It's rated R for restriction? Yeah, you should not watch
this play that.
Trailer.
Not going to play that. That trailer's restricted.
Mm-hmm.
Magic Mike.
Mm-hmm.
Magic Mike is Tammy's suggestion. If I could find a trailer that was not rated R, I would play that, but...
Yeah, we have certain ethics on this.
I'm so glad they had that green screen up before.
Yeah.
I almost played a rated R trailer for everybody.
Glad it was someone else and not me.
Mm-hmm.
So, that's good.
Do you want to go ahead and give your other... Which I don't know if there's
Tropic
a
Thunder.
Safe trailer for Tropic Thunder either.
Tropic Thunder. I laughed so hard throughout this entire movie. At first, I didn't realize that it was a parody, but every character in this, but I thought he was great. You know,
yeah.
I just thought he
Matthew
was great.
Matthew McConaughey in Tropic Thunder.
Yeah, this was a super fun movie.
It was. This is one where you want to go and just laugh.
It's really... You know who's really, who also does a really phenomenal job and plays just a peripheral role is Tom Cruise.
Oh,
that's right, yeah.
He insisted that he wasn't going to play the role unless they put really fat hands on him.
I did not know that.
He wore prosthetics over his...
Arms?
Yeah.
For the whole movie. And then for that part that he played. Matthew McConaughey's part is pretty different in this, but what a funny movie.
It is.
The little pandas. Uh-huh.
Mm. They're also good.
They were all pretty much over the top in Tropic Thunder.
They were.
Just.
All right. Kelly's going to start laughing. She won't be able to handle it.
I know. So okay.
I'm going to throw out, and I know Kelly pointed this a while ago for me, We Are Marshall, of course, about the Marshall football team. And I thought he did a phenomenal job of playing that coach.
That's something I've never seen.
You have not seen that movie?
No.
And I know it's just probably not the sports guy like myself.
I've lived away for too
and
long.
I am a football mom.
Right.
See, I mean, that used to be my
I also mm-hmm. haven't seen my any Friday Night Lights.
Mom. Really?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, you should watch We Are Marshall.
Because
two, it's a... You know, it's a newsworthy movie because of the events of the Marshall football team when they died in this plane crash.
Oh, man.
And that's what it's about.
Mm-hmm.
He plays the coach that came in and rebuilt the Marshall football team after the crash.
And the one or two survivors that weren't on the plane, team members.
Yeah, for whatever reason, they were injured or whatnot. They were not on the team plane when they went down and died. I mean, because everybody on that plane died. Coaches, there were only a few coaches and players that survived.
And he wasn't just rebuilding a football team. He was rebuilding a community.
Right.
Yeah.
Because it was such a tragic loss.
But it's really a good movie. And he does a really phenomenal job. If you go back and look at the mannerisms of that coach that he portrays in the movie, it's like he studied him and was on. So, yeah. He does it really well.
You know, I should go back and revisit a few things like Friday Night Lights and this, We Are Marshall, because it's always nice to see. I grew up here, and it's always nice to see representations of our area or you know the region that aren't Westerns.
Right. You know? Right.
And although it's similar in genre, we were talking about Hell or High Water.
Right.
As one of those movies that's really, really phenomenally done and shows West Texas.
Yeah, as it really kind of is represented. Right. So as opposed to everybody riding on horses and...
Right.
Feeding their cows around their oil wells.
And it's funny because people in other parts of the country really do think that we ride horses.
To work every day.
Yeah. And some people do.
Well...
By the way, yours needs some water.
Out of state up on in North Carolina at an airport, and a lady said, "Where are you from?" And I said, "West Texas." "Are you a Texas Ranger?" She leaned up. I was like, it was some big secret. We're in a public place. I'm like, "Why, yes, I am."
As a matter of fact,
gave it away.
It happens at birth.
I saw your badge.
Oh, on your ring. Because you have a...
Oh,
wow.
So that was me being bad. I'm not a Texas Ranger. I've never been a Texas Ranger, but I could not help myself.
But you play one on the Derailed webcast.
No,
but
awesome.
But she is a Marshall.
Yeah. Awesome.
All right, I'm gonna go with one.
Okay.
Okay.
Interstellar.
Oh, yes. Good movie.
Yeah. Yes.
Yeah. I really, really enjoy science fiction.
Mm-hmm.
I also really enjoy dystopian science fiction. So this is sort of the hopeful... sci-fi mixed in with the everything is going terrible at the same time.
It was a great movie.
Yeah, really well made.
And it was, again, a completely different type of role for him.
Yeah.
I mean, not from what I was accustomed to watching him.
Yeah, and it's one of those things that you also don't see all that often is with his accent being presented as, you know, this brilliant scientist and astronaut, you're not used to seeing that representation in Hollywood of somebody who has those two things together.
Mm-hmm.
But all of it, stylistically, really great movie.
So how many have we talked about?
No idea.
We're past 10, I'm sure, by far. But is there one that you were looking at?
One I never saw was this one.
Oh, and that's the one I was about to talk about, Mud.
I haven't seen that either.
It is really a good movie.
Is it with two Ds?
No, just one.
So is he a bad guy in that movie, or
I don't want to give it away.
Okay.
So I would say you just need to watch it.
Okay.
And go check it out. So the premise of this movie, if I remember correctly, there was I gotta pull it back up so I can see it correctly. There's a couple of little boys that are exploring an island, and they find Matthew McConaughey out there, who is a fugitive, I guess, if you want to say.
Okay.
He doesn't exactly have a squeaky clean past, let's put
right.
it that way. So, and it's just, it's a good overall plot. And he kind of asked for their help, the two boys, and they decide to help him. And so, it's a pretty cool movie. So I would go check it out and just check it out.
Okay.
I don't want to give it away. So
if he's not a villain in this movie, it just occurred to me that I'd really like to see a movie where he is a villain. He usually plays the protagonist, right?
Sure.
He's usually the lead. And it would be really interesting to see a movie where he's the bad guy.
Well, he's not exactly the good guy, let's say that.
Okay.
it's not like he's
running from his past.
Yeah, you
Reese
could say that.
Though. She's a really great actress.
Yeah, it's a good movie. Good overall movie.
Okay.
I would check it out.
So let's see.
And if Cody was here, let's give one for Cody Brown today because
okay,
Dazed and Confused.
Of course,
of course, yeah.
The quintessential, because right. everybody knows. All right.
You know what? I meant to make that joke when we were talking about his class. I meant to say, how do you think his class is going?
All right.
It's probably peaked at 300 with, and there will be no drops.
No, yeah.
No drops.
I wonder if there's going to be any guys in the class. If it was filled up with all these females right off the bat when they heard that, oh, yeah, select.
Right.
So they're making their other guy friends drop the class so they can get in it.
Or how many kinesiology majors
sure.
and accounting majors are taking a film class as
mm-hmm.
an elective.
Right.
Yeah,
right.
They are.
You know? So.
All of a sudden. But Dazed and Confused, golly.
There are a lot of actors in this that you don't really see much of anymore, except for him.
You know that that's a Cody Brown probably number one pick.
Oh, sure.
As far as a Matthew McConaughey
film. It's
sort
of a classic movie.
So.
At this point.
Was that a trunk full of beer? Did I forget that scene? See, this
is
you were
probably dazed and confused when you were watching it, Kelly.
I was Agwell. No comment there.
Well, this is,
no, I was a mother who had kids who were watching this,
mm-hmm.
and they were loving it.
And
of course, yeah.
They were.
We talked about it. Was high school really like this in the 70s? You know, I mean.
Kind of. Because I was in high school
right.
in the 70s.
This was a movie for high school kids in the 90s,
mm-hmm.
so that they could see what high school was like in the 70s.
For their parents.
Right.
And see, I guess when I did watch this one time, because my oldest daughter, who's now 36, loved it, and my son, Stuart, was now 33, I think he was in junior high when this was going on. And he thought it was so funny because of how they dressed.
He plays such a bad person in this.
Yeah, there's your bad guy.
Yeah, this actually
he is a bad guy.
The ultimately
yeah.
bad person.
Just for the one line.
Actually awful.
Just for the one line of
yeah, uh-huh.
you don't about high school girls. Uh-huh. Let's just say that. So if you haven't seen the movie, mm-hmm. go check it out. So.
Oh,
you know what? My brother just.
Threw out a
he
another.
Did. He well, he threw out that he does play a bad guy in one movie, and it is unfortunately, it doesn't belong on this top 10.
Okay.
It's
not a McConaughey film.
It is a McConaughey film. It's just an awful McConaughey film.
Hmm.
The Dark Tower.
I think I remember
the Dark
that.
Tower.
Yeah,
I don't
so
know.
So they
if
made
I know
a movie
that.
Out of the Stephen King novel.
Yes.
Matthew McConaughey plays the Man in Black. And Idris Elba plays the gunslinger.
Mm-hmm.
If anybody's read these novels, the Stephen King gunslinger, Dark Tower novels, it's sort of a mixture of fantasy, science fiction, and a western all at the same time.
Yes.
Oh, wow.
Plus, and this is not that old.
No, this is not that old. They botched it.
Yes.
The filmmakers botched it very badly.
Remember seeing the trailer for it and thinking, oh, wow.
Yeah.
Because it was... kind of, I don't want to say out there, but it was just so different.
It is. And I mean, these novels have spanned Stephen King's mm-hmm. entire career.
Right.
He started writing them in the 70s, and I've been reading them since I was a little kid.
That explains a lot about you, Jeff.
Yeah. I mean, the ideas that are going through these are wild. And mm-hmm.
that's the best way to write it instead of, oh, I'll say it's out there. Well, it's wild. Yeah.
Yeah, I mean.
It is.
But it deserves better than this movie.
Okay, I'm going to have to actually watch it because I remember seeing the trailer and thinking, Matthew McConaughey. But, yeah. Ooh, look at that guy with the big gun.
Imagine that. You said that about Matthew McConaughey.
And, mm-hmm. I mean, yeah, I'm sure a lot of people both said, ooh, Matthew McConaughey and, ooh, Idris Elba.
Mm-hmm.
But the books are better.
Okay.
But good catch, yes. JC.
So
let's see. There was the other one for you, Kelly. I was going to scroll back to because I remembered you said something about it. This one, right? Was it this one, or you were pointing at that one? Okay.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I'll go with this one.
Mm-hmm,
Sahara.
Mm-hmm, 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 mm-hmm.
Which I don't know that it's one of his top ten. It was just one of those movies that was just not. It wasn't a waste of your time.
Okay.
It wasn't phenomenal either, but it was a good one. Had Penelope Cruz. I love Steve Zahn.
Okay.
He cracks me up. So, and he plays a hilarious role in this.
I didn't
but
know
yeah,
that I've ever seen this.
I never saw it. I remember that was in my days when I had a 5-year-old.
Yeah, you had no time for anything.
I had one in college, one in high school, one in kindergarten, and one in diapers. So I didn't get to do a lot of movies. So
sure.
I do remember.
Yeah, but I liked it. It was a good role. I mean, it's. Well, I think I liked it a lot just because, like it's I said, I like Steve Zahn. So.
It's an adventure mm-hmm. movie.
Yeah, mm-hmm. it is.
So mm-hmm. that makes it super interesting.
Penelope Cruz is pretty.
Yeah.
So.
Otherwise, wow, I don't know anything about this. For a second, I thought it was the movie about the plane going down in the desert.
And no, them it's all. Not at all.
This is a lot more along the lines of an Indiana Jones style
mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Adventure heist kind of thing.
Steve that guy's always so funny.
Steve Zahn is
he
hilarious.
Is so funny.
That's why I love him.
He is.
So.
All right.
Well,
we only got, what, about 5 minutes left?
Yeah.
And you know, his mama is so proud of him.
Steve Zahn's? Yeah, she.
Oh, well, yeah,
or
her too.
Matthew McConaughey's. No, we're back on him.
She, yeah, well, it's a top 10.
Oh, yeah. Top 10 Matthew McConaughey movies.
He is just an approachable Texas boy.
Yeah,
and,
he is.
I just think he's awesome, and he loves his mom, and he's good to his family, and he's proud of his wife, and adores his wife, and they're beautiful children. So I just think he is a good guy.
You know, that's the impression that I get also, that he's just a really good guy in general.
And, I think he's proud to be a Texan.
Sure.
I think he's a proud Texan. So
So I've got one that I haven't seen, but I want to.
Oh, look at
which
that.
Is
Gold.
Mm. Oh yeah.
I'd really like to see this.
Yeah, I haven't seen this
he
either.
Put on a lot of weight. I guess, you know, did some prosthetic stuff for his hair. I'm assuming he put on a lot of weight because it certainly doesn't look like they put him in a fat suit. If they did, they're exceptional makeup artists.
Well, if he lost the 45 pounds for Dallas Buyers Club, I'm sure he could put on the weight to do it. I mean, and he did so much to his body.
He and Christian Bale are in a race, it seems.
Yeah, to see who can go from fat to skinny to muscular.
Christian Bale's done it twice now.
Yeah.
But this movie looks really interesting. Somebody was telling me that the plot was, you know, they go and they say that they've got a gold mine and they're trying to get investors to give more money. So what they're doing is they're seeding. They're
putting gold in.
Yeah, they're mm-hmm. showing that they're getting gold, and they're sending a little bit of gold to these investors to be like, "See, look, we're getting gold." So they're seeding the investors, and it's a scam.
Hmm.
And it looks really interesting. So maybe he plays a bad guy in this.
Could be a seedy character.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Well, hey, can I say one thing?
Yeah,
before
sure.
we completely derail?
We're about
derail?
To wrap up.
Okay. Mm-hmm. I have to mention this. Next Monday, Labor Day, because I don't know if y'all are ever going to have me back.
We'll definitely have you back.
Why wouldn't we have you back? Yeah.
But next Monday, Labor Day, there's an event going on at Kirby Park, and it's open to the public. It's by the newly formed Republican Hispanic National Assembly.
Okay.
And it's from 12:30 to 5:30. There will be burgers and hot dogs available for sale, but there's a car show. They're going to have some guest speakers. Rafael Cruz, Senator Ted Cruz's father, will be there.
Oh. Mm.
Carmen Crenshaw, she's the state chairperson for the Republican Hispanic National Assembly. She'll be a guest speaker. Joe Vargas, who is the founder and CEO of Keep Texas Red. And okay. I'm really not here just to talk about politics, but I mean, I'm going to throw that out there.
Well, obviously not, because we've been talking about Matthew McConaughey for the last 25 minutes.
Got to bring us back to reality so. Now. And George Bean, I'm going to say his name wrong, but another guest speaker as well.
Okay.
So
well played.
It'll be a fun
Don't
day.
Don't butcher that name.
To spend your afternoon on Labor Day, have some traditional all-American burgers and dogs,
oh,
and
nice.
Trophies and prizes for the car show, and Sam Gomez is the coordinator for that event. So I feel like okay. I have to tell you all about that.
I mean, it's always nice to go to Kirby Park.
Yeah.
Especially on Labor Day, enjoy some barbecue.
Yeah.
Or I'm sorry.
That's fine.
In other parts
burgers.
Of the country.
Yeah.
They call it barbecue.
Sure.
They're just burgers.
Going to do some grilling of some burgers and dogs.
There
it's
you go.
It's going to be so good.
Grilled burgers and dogs.
Mm-hmm.
It's not barbecue. Don't go expecting brisket.
And then on Monday, the next Monday, September 9th, come see us at the San Angelo Republican Women and hear Judge Dusick's presentation on the court system in Texas and what each court does. It'll be a great.
Yeah. Jeff's going to come.
Don't miss it.
Right. Yeah, and register to vote before October 7th.
Yeah, don't forget to do that.
Yes.
We want you voting.
Okay.
All right. Kelly, thanks for coming by today.
You're
Thank
welcome.
You.
It's been fun.
Yeah,
you're welcome.
It's been a good show.
I love you.
We'll bring you back.
You're my friend. It's so nice to meet you. Very nice to meet you.
All right, guys. We're out of here.
See you tomorrow.
It's Thursday, right?
Hmm?
Yeah. It's Thursday,
what, me?
Right?
It is Thursday.
Okay.
Tomorrow, I will actually be here. I'll be on the show, and then I'll be on the road.
Oh,
for the Central Football broadcast.
That's right.
Because we start back Friday Night Football.
Yeah,
of course, tonight, Mason and Wall playing down at the Puncher Dome. So it should be a good game there.
Ooh.
We'll have highlights tonight. So,
all right.
That'll be a good game.
Okay. All right, everyone.
Thanks.
Have a good afternoon.
And we're done.
Yeah, clip it.